చెప్పుతాయి సార్ అక్కడ నేను అక్కడ వదిలేసుకుని ఇక్కడ ఇంపోర్ట్ చేయమని మీతో కూడా ఒకసారి అన్నాను తమరితో కూడా అంటే చెప్తున్నాను సార్ ఇప్పుడు ఏంటంటే మనీ ఈజ్ రూట్ ఆఫ్ వాల్యూస్ డబ్బులు సార్ ఏవి ఆగిపోతాయి సార్ 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 ఏమనుకోకండి సార్ మీ దృష్టికి ఏంటంటే మాకు ఫాదర్ లాంటి సార్
మంచిది Right. 2:33. Wait for 2 more minutes. Any one of you, please just tell me on the chat box. So what was the last discussion I was doing? I have deleted that part of the last screen. Check up your notes and tell me what was the discussion. I think I was discussing characteristics of equilibrium constant. Is it the same or anything else? Please tell me. Effective from the interior. Yes, yes. Excellent. Thank you very much. Thank you. Nice. Oh, very good. Fine. Now, 2:34. 1 minute. Shoaib Ahmed, Muhammad Shoaib Ahmed, you don't have roll number, you don't have section number. Change it, otherwise I'll remove you. I'll give 3 minutes, change it, otherwise I'll remove you. And anybody is having, I am not going to, I don't have that much time to see all those unnecessary things. Change yourself or else go out of the class. Shoaib Ahmed, roll number and section is required. Now, in the previous class, we were discussing about effect of temperature on equilibrium constant. We have discussed so many points. In between one point, I have said that there is a equilibrium constant is affected by temperature. That's all. I said that much. Now the question is how it is affected by temperature. It's a very beautiful long story. Therefore, I have not taken it. It is to be done separately. It is to be done separately. It is additional information. And especially for IIT students, it is very useful. Effect of temperature on equilibrium constant, capital K. Now, the question is, whenever we are discussing any chemical reaction, this can be discussed in number of ways, right? I can enjoy this topic with the different directions and different angles. Let us see how to proceed. For that purpose, what we do, enjoyment number one. Suppose, for example, you are having a chemical reaction AA, BB gives you, our normal way of discussion is something like this. It's my favorite reaction. Now, if suppose we want to study the effect of temperature and equilibrium constant, I have to discuss about what is delta H for this reaction. Enthalpy change, go back to thermochemistry, there we have discussed all this. So when you are discussing this delta H, then there is a possibility of different questions or different ways. What is that? Come on, number one, number two, number three. Three cases I can enjoy. Number one, suppose for example, if delta H is more than zero. Okay, it means to say I am discussing endothermic reaction. What is the meaning of endothermic reaction? Endothermic reaction means forward reaction requires energy. If you give energy, remember, whenever you say the word endothermic or exothermic, that is with respect to forward or backward direction, right? It is with respect to forward always because we want to go in forward direction. For backward, he has to mention that. Without mentioning anything, if he says the reaction is exothermic, it means to say he is dealing with respect to forward direction. So when I am saying it is endothermic reaction, it means if I supply temperature, equilibrium shifts to forward direction. Reaction shifts to forward direction, right? Now, if suppose, for example, you are saying so, what is the meaning of that? Come on. Before going there, let us take one more information. Wait a minute. Okay, not possible to adjust. For this reaction, K is equal to molar concentration of C, molar concentration of D, molar concentration of A, molar concentration of B. Now, suppose for example, if you are saying, sir, I am talking about effect of temperature, then case number one, if delta H is more than zero, it means which process? Endothermic. What is the meaning of that? As temperature increases, rate of forward reaction increases. What is the meaning of rate of forward reaction increases? It means to say we get more and more amount of C and D. That means concentration of products, I'll write here, concentration of products increases. When you are saying concentration of product increases, numerator increases, it implies what happens? K value increases, right? Remember, if we are discussing the rate of forward reaction increases, indirectly we are saying that the concentration of products are increasing, and when concentration of products increases, numerical value of K increases. So what is my conclusion? My conclusion is, as you increase the temperature, equilibrium constant increases. In which case? In endothermic reactions, right? So yesterday what we have said, equilibrium constant is affected by temperature. How it is affected? You cannot say generally. First of all, you have to discuss which case, exo or endothermic. Okay. No, sir, not like this. Suppose, for example, that fellow says, if delta H is less than zero, what is that reaction? Exothermic. Exothermic reaction means reactants are already having more energy. Reactants are having already more energy. And if you supply temperature, then what happens? Those reactant molecules will deny that. They will not accept the energy. And what a product molecule says, we are in need of energy, therefore let us receive that one. So if you are supplying heat energy, if you are increasing temperature, whoever is in need of that, they will take. The remaining people will not take that one. That is the honesty of the reactants and products. Therefore, if it is exothermic reaction, reactant says, we don't have requirement of energy. Already we are having more amount of energy. Go to those poor fellows, the products, they are in need of energy. So energy will be given, temperature will be utilized by products C and D. Hence reaction goes in backward direction. That means if you are increasing temperature, as the temperature increases, rate of backward reaction increases. What is the meaning of rate of backward reaction increases? We get more and more concentration of reactants, concentration of R. R may not be comfortable to your mind. Let us say reactants. Concentration of reactants increases. Right? If you are saying concentration of reactant increases, it is a denominator. So if you are increasing this K value, decreases. Yes. Okay. Now we got an information that effect of temperature on equilibrium state decided by exothermic or endothermic nature of chemical reaction. And suppose, for example, if you say, sir, we are having a case where, let us go back and come from this direction. Okay. Now suppose, for example, you are saying, sir, no, not like that. If delta H equals to zero, neither loss of energy nor gain of energy, if you are supplying temperature, everyone says we don't require energy, we are in comfortable zone, therefore no effect, K is unaffected by temperature. Okay, this is a discussion suitable. This is one way of enjoying that discussion. The second way of enjoyment is, this is suitable, section A is suitable, style 1 is suitable for doctors. Come on, come to enjoy this with the scientists. What they will say, sir, we want mathematical proof, right? What you are saying, theoretically, absolutely comfortable to our mind, but we are MPC students, we want to enjoy that. No problem. For that purpose, we have to remember one equation, equilibrium constant K. Right, the beauty of this equation you can learn in second year chapter. You have to just take care of this. K is equal to some constant into e power minus delta H by RT. All these are known to us, but we have to know that equation. The derivation of this equation available, but I don't declare that one not suitable. But once you meet me with an advanced discussion, yes, for that it is suitable. Come on. If it is so, apply log K is equal to log of constant. What is that constant also? We can discuss minus delta H by R into 1 by T. Right? No, sir. Let us take the common log. Common log to the base 10 is equal to log of constant minus delta H by 2.303 R. Is it got the point? We are converting natural log to common log, multiply by 2.303, it becomes like this. If it is so, then come on, Y is equal to minus MX plus C. This is the story. Now, if you want to enjoy this, then we can say, sir, we are having two type of graphs available. Right? First graph is, suppose for example, I want to take a plot of log K. Be careful about this one. Log K. Right? And I have taken here 1 by T. Then minus mx plus C. Minus mx plus C. What will be the shape of the graph? Negative slope. Shape of the graph will be like this. Log K value is decreasing, right? No, it is decreasing because of 1 by T. 1 by T, if you take the value of T, it increases. Therefore, this graph is for which reaction? Endothermic. Remember that. That means delta H is positive. I got this negative into positive. Minus, go ahead. Suppose, for example, here what I should write, delta H more than 0. Suppose if I am saying delta H less than 0, it is negative. Minus of minus, plus. So log Y is equal to MX plus C. If it is so, the graph will be something like this. Log K is equal to, if I take 1 by T, Y is equal to MX plus C, you are saying, plus C, right? Which type of graph? This type of graph. Slope of the graph, you can take as delta H. I'll write here separately. This is for which reaction? Exothermic reaction. They are individual 4 marks question for doctors and for scientists both. This is delta H by dash 2.303 R. This is one way of understanding. There is one more way of understanding this topic, right? Effect of temperature. That can be done in different ways. What is that? See here. Suppose, for example, I am saying, sir, I am having this equation, log K. Then let us change the temperature. Consider T1 low temperature, T2 high temperature. Now apply this equation. What will happen? Nothing will happen, sir. Log K2 high temperature I am taking is equal to log of that constant. What is that constant? We learn later on. Not necessary now. Delta H by 2.303 R 1 upon, what is that? T2 high temperature. Cheating. Log of K2. Log of K1 is equal to log of constant minus delta H by 2.303 R 1 by T1. If you divide this equation, it becomes log of K2 by, by K1 is equal to, this gets cancelled. We get delta H, chepandi. No, they should write only, wait a minute, for a minute, but so students, just wait for a minute. KVPY students, go, let them prepare only KVPY, right? There are two NEET students. For them, they have to go through respective NEET paper, Excel corner or other, they have to go. Today morning, I discussed with them. And those who are having KVPY, they should do only work with respect to KVPY till 31st of January, right? 25th nunchi daily there is one paper for KVPY for all the students. Examination will be started from 25th onwards. All of the exam, college exam later. Okay.
So then
Deniki remaining valaka. Aa paper ichestam manam.
Idi senior Excel 1.
Ha, Excel 1 lo aa NEET valaku NEET aa paper koncham. Aa syllabus koncham cheppandi valaku.
Okay.
This is 1 by T1. Minus 1 by T2. Right. Now, this is also a way to enjoy the beauty of the question. This is equation. Scientists, we have to remember this. Yes, a beautiful relation. Those students who are gaming for aiming for aims, yes, then they can enjoy this all mathematical treatment. They should be strong in maths. Then it is suitable. Otherwise, NEET is possible. No problem. Come on. Now, case 1, if delta H is positive, what is the meaning of that? This delta H positive means this is positive. This is always positive. Why? T2 minus T1 by T1 T2, if you simplify, it becomes T2 minus T1 by T1 T2. Okay, so this is positive. It is also positive. Whole term is positive. Log of K2 by K1 is positive means K2 is more than K1. This implies K2 is more than K1. What is the meaning of that? This implies as the temperature increases, K is increasing. No, sir. The reaction is supposed to be delta H less than 0. Exothermic reaction. Negative. This is positive. This is negative. Minus into plus minus. This whole term is negative. Log of K2 by K1 is negative means K2 is less than K1. This implies as I am going to T2, higher temperature, K2 is decreasing. Therefore, remember that depending upon the thermo nature of reaction, whether delta H positive or negative, we can explain variation of equilibrium constant. Okay, go ahead. 71, 75, 77, 78. Last week. What was the syllabus? What is the syllabus? Last week, what was the syllabus? Shall I proceed? Is it over? Go ahead, go ahead. That is the problem, Muhammad Khan. That is your big problem from the initial stage. I am saying that when you are, I am discussing this one, you are going to thermodynamics. And last time also, last before week, every week you are having the same immature type of behavior. So that is causing your concentration to change. Therefore, you may have doubt. Anyhow, I'll check the paper, but please try to change your way of doing work. Otherwise, जिस वक्त जो काम हो रहा है ध्यान उसी पे होना। मैं आपको अब बात कर रहा हूँ इसकी, आप कुछ और बात करना है, टाइम पास करने आ गया। वो लास्ट टाइम तीन वक्त बोल दिया मैं जुमला आपके लिए के यू आर सिंपली अ टाइम पास कैंडिडेट, स्टिल यू आर डूइंग सेम, यू कंसंट्रेट ऑन दिस वन, राइट? आप लिखना छोड़ के एक नई चीज पूछना है। क्लास के बाद में क्लास जब खत्म होती ना, जब मैं बोलता हूँ इट्स नाउ क्लास इज ओवर राइट शैल आई पैक अप, उस वक्त ये चीजें बोले तो हम समझते कि आप स्टूडेंट हैं। बाद में बीच बीच में अगर ऐसा पूछे तो हम समझते कि आप तो टाइम पास टाइप करने वाले हैं, तफरी हम चुप आ गए, ना आपको दिलचस्पी है पढ़ने से ना आपको पढ़ने की तमीज है। ये हमारा रिएक्शन इमेज आपका ये है मेरे लिए फाइनल वर्ड इज इट ओवर। जिस वक्त जो काम होगा उस पर ध्यान दिए तो उसको बल्कि सक्सेस Shall I proceed? Is it over? Fine. Now we have completed one task. What is equilibrium reaction? What are the types of variations of equilibrium? Graphs. Then what is equilibrium state? Factors affecting equilibrium state. What is equilibrium constant? How many types of equilibrium constant? What is relation between them? What are the factors in that one? ये एक rhythm है, पढ़ने का एक rhythm। जब आप study करने बैठते हैं, तो ये rhythm देखना, headings कैसे कैसे चल रहा है। Enjoy करना। Now, suppose for example you are discussing the equilibrium reaction, reversible reaction of equilibrium. Let us see one more very beautiful way of enjoyment. Suppose for example if I am having a chemical reaction A. Gives you A plus B gives you C plus D. Nice. Now for this chemical reaction, suppose for example if I am saying sir, basically when you are discussing equilibrium constant, what you are doing? You are doing nothing sir, simply you are adding molar concentration of products by molar concentration of reactants. That means you are taking the ratio of concentration of the C value, C concentration of B, and dividing it by concentration of A and B. If it is so, then one student says, sir, why don't we do it like this? Suppose, for example, if I am writing the situation in this way, suppose I am saying, sir, I am having concentration of C, power C, concentration of B, power B, by concentration of B, power B, concentration of C power C, but at any time not equal to time of attainment of equilibrium. What is the meaning of that? This means to say, suppose roll number one is doing this reaction and let us say he is getting the equilibrium state after 30 minutes. After 30 minutes, what is the meaning of getting equilibrium? Rf is equal to Rb, rate of forward reaction becomes equal to rate of backward reaction. All macroscopic properties remains constant. If it is so, it is called equilibrium state. It is available after 30 minutes. Rule number one is saying, no, I am not taking in 30 minutes. I am taking after 10 minutes. I am taking after 15 minutes, 20 minutes, or 25 minutes. But any time other than equilibrium time, then this ratio is given a symbol as Q, and this Q is known as reaction quotient. It is known as reaction quotient. What is reaction quotient? Very simple, sir. Reaction quotient is ratio of molar concentration of products to that of reactants raised to stoichiometric coefficient, but at any time other than time of attainment of equilibrium. That is called reaction quotient. And what is K? K is equilibrium constant. What is equilibrium constant? Same thing, sir. Concentration of C, concentration of B, concentration of B, concentration of A, as it is. Now it comes C and B, unnecessarily, okay. This is A and this is B. Fine. Now, this is supposed to be concentration of A and concentration of B, but what is that but? But it is at time t exactly equal to time of attainment of equilibrium. Say, for example, for rule number one, I said 30 minutes. If you are measuring the concentration, this concentration is different, this concentration is different. This is supposed to be constant concentration when RF is equal to RB. Therefore, this implies when we are discussing this, then we are having a beautiful way of enjoying that. Suppose Q is less than K. Okay. Remember, Q is variable quantity and K is constant quantity. Constant K depends only upon temperature. Once you say reaction is fixed, nature is fixed. Therefore, Q is variable at time t is equal to 10 minutes, 15 minutes, 20 minutes, 25 minutes. At every time it is having different value because C value is goes on changing along with the D. A value and B value also changing. But when you go to time 30 minutes, K remains constant. K remains constant. That means Q is variable and it may be less than K. If it is less than time of attainment, if it is so, what is the meaning of that? Point number one, reaction is not at equilibrium. Statement number one, straightforward. No, no, sir. Reaction is tending towards forward direction. Yes. And what is forward direction? Forward direction towards equilibrium. So reaction is tending towards, approaching towards equilibrium. Okay, next. Suppose, for example, you say, sir, it goes on increasing and increasing and increasing, and K becomes equal to Q becomes equal to K. Then reaction is at equilibrium. At equilibrium. And once you're having this one, then you have so many conditions, sir. RF is equal to RB. Here, RF is more than RB. Remember this, right? Q is less than K. Doctors, this is a 4 marks question for you. And suppose, for example, you say, no, sir, Q is more than K. Is it possible? Never. Never is possible. Why is it not possible? In the previous classes, when we have discussed the concept of equilibrium state, we said, once equilibrium state is attained, molar concentration of all the reactants and products becomes constant. And once it is constant, it will remain constant for one day, for 1 week, for 1 month, for 1 year, as long as you are not disturbing that. Otherwise, it remains constant. So Q is not possible. How it is possible to have Q more than K? You should disturb that. You should disturb that. Q more than K, it means reaction is not at equilibrium. Number one, RF is less than RB. Yes, who is dominating now? Backward reaction. Okay, reaction is tending towards equilibrium. No, reaction is going back to the previous direction, backward direction. That is the meaning of Q more than K, right? With the value of Q in case of numerical problems, we'll try to justify, we'll try to find out whether the reaction is towards forward direction or towards backward direction or it is at equilibrium. That is the advantage of knowledge of reaction quotient. Right. Coming to the next discussion. Suppose, for example, you are saying that, sir, I am talking about a chemical reaction, a reversible chemical reaction. Say, for example, A. Why A? Okay. I am talking about a chemical reaction. A N gives you N A. Once I declare this one, then you can say, sir, this is nothing but dissociation reaction. Dissociation. This is one molecule and we are getting large number of molecules. So this is an example of dissociation reaction. And if you are having dissociation reaction, let us see how to enjoy the way of writing the dissociation in equilibrium process. Okay, for doctors, I'll give first a simple example. How to proceed for that one? That example is 2HI gives you H2 plus I2. Okay, now how to proceed for that in problems? I'm solving actually problems in theoretical side. Time t is equal to 0. This is concentration given as 1. In chemical equilibrium, we start with, say for example, 1. This is 0. This is 0. Time t is equal to time of attainment of equilibrium. Out of 1, something is going out. That is known as degree of dissociation, alpha. Right? So if it is alpha, it must be how much? two moles are converting to one mole alpha by 2. Two moles are converting to one alpha by 2. You have to learn this method of writing the equation. What we are studying? Sir, we are studying degree of dissociation. Symbol is alpha. Come on. This is the simple way of writing. No, no, sir. Problem is not like this. Problem is something different. See how to enjoy that. 2HI gives you H2 plus I2.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon. If time t is equal to 0, say for example, you said A. 0, 0. This is you have taken one mole. But in the question he has given, you have to go accordingly. Time t is equal to t. Rule number 1. Sir, a minus x. Go ahead. He is taking like this. What is the meaning of a minus x? Out of a moles, x moles are dissociated. X moles are converted. Nice. 2 moles gives you 1 mole. X moles gives you x by 2. 2 moles gives you 1 mole. X moles gives you x by 2. Now the question is, what is this x? Is it degree of dissociation? No, that we have to learn here. It is not degree of dissociation. What is degree of dissociation? Degree of dissociation is something out of one. Short and sweet definition. Something out of one. How many moles are coming out of one? Yes, it is degree of dissociation. But here, x is not degree of dissociation. How to proceed? Very simple, sir. If it is a moles, x moles are coming. If it is one mole, how many moles? This is called alpha. What is alpha? Alpha is x by a. In the examination, you can start like this. Safest method is 100. No, no, sir. I want to go like this. Go ahead. You can enjoy in this manner. Okay. One boy says, no, sir, I want to enjoy a different man. Right? His thought process is going like this. 2HI gives you H2 plus I2. Right? Like time t is equal to 0, A, 0, 0. Now he says time t is equal to t, A minus 2x. I'm asking, why you are writing 2? Sir, see here, 2 moles are going. Okay, 2. What I have read here? X only. See this one, x by 2. No, no, x. Now the question is, what is alpha? This is not alpha, right? Again, the same story. For a moles, we are getting 2x moles. For 1 mole, how much? Therefore, degree of dissociation is 2x by a. Therefore, whatever with the way with which we are proceeding to find out the degree of dissociation, enjoy the basic concept. How many out of one is called degree of dissociation? Go ahead.
ఓన్లీ మనం రిజిస్టర్ వర్క్ చేసుకుంటున్నారా, రిజిస్టర్ వర్క్ కంప్లీట్ చేసుకుంటున్నారా అని అక్కడ పిలవండి, వాళ్ళ కింద పిలవండి, ఇక్కడ కూర్చొని నా ముందు చేసి ఫైనల్ ఇవ్వండి చెప్పండి. ఇప్పుడు ఎవరు ఫ్రీ ఉన్నారో వాళ్ళకి తెలియండి, ఇక్కడ కూర్చొని చేస్తే ఆ రిపోర్ట్ మనకు 6 o'clock కావాలి. రైట్ అయితే సార్ యా రైటింగ్.
That is the way with which we discuss the degree of dissociation. Now, there is a question. What is the question? If suppose you are having, listened carefully the question, because today I am creating question, answer will be given tomorrow. I am going to teach tomorrow that topic. Sir, you are saying that we are having hydrogen iodide gives you H2 plus. Take this example, one example, suppose, right? Or you can have another example. Let us take like this. What is that example? See this. It's a beautiful example to enjoy the game. PCl5 dissociates to give you PCl3 and Cl2. Now, suppose if it is like this, then at time t is equal to 0, we have alone PCl5. Alone PCl5. What is molecular weight? Molecular weight of PCl5. Simple. Suppose, for example, you are saying that time t is equal to 10 minutes, 20 minutes, 30 minutes. After 30 minutes, or at 30 minutes, I got equilibrium. And at that time, what is available? PCl5 is available, PCl3 is available, Cl2 is also available, right? All the three are available. Now, if I ask you, what is the molecular weight? Your first reaction will be, sir, how can you say molecular weight? Molecular weight is the property of single substance. How can you go to ask that molecular weight of PCl5, PCl3 and Cl2 mixture? Yes, go back to your stoichiometry or gaseous state. There you have said, that it is called mean molar mass, molecular mass of mixture. Yes. So our question here in this case is, whenever chemical reactions are at equilibrium stage, what is the molecular mass? It is not good to say what is the molecular mass. The correct way of saying is, what is the mean molar mass? What is the equilibrium molecular mass? If it is so, right, then if you are calculating mean molar mass, there will be also a chance to calculate density, because volume of the vessel, reaction vessel, remains the same. Therefore, there is one more heading which is created now, is called mean density. That is density at equilibrium. Now, next topic here in this case is how to find out density at equilibrium, how to find out mean molar mass at equilibrium. That is related with respect to degree of dissociation that we'll discuss in the next class. Any question to ask till this point today, whatever we have done, our chemical equilibrium from first class to this class, any question to ask? Now it is the time to discuss with me, not in between as our one unwanted boy is saying every time. Anybody to ask any question? Welcome. Question connected to syllabus, which is going on now. Any question? All right, nothing is there. I'll stop it here. Remaining discussion will be in the next class. Thank you. Assalamu alaikum.